this is Teddy from Switzerland with another video, and today we're going to talk about my top picks of the SHOT Show 2017. And the input for this video came from a couple of knife guys that I talked with on Instagram. Doctorfrunky also did a video like that and tagged me in that, so I am certainly going to make one. Also, Nick Shabazz, who you certainly all know, has done a video like this, as well as Kevin Cleary. And here I have some eye candy for you that you can look at while I'm talking. I will also inlay the pictures of the knife we are going to talk about in the video as well. So first off, you all know SHOT Show has ended a couple of days ago, and a lot of new knives were introduced in that show, and let's take a look at which knives stood out to me. I also tried to pick some different ones that weren't already mentioned. So first, let's get the elephant out of the room, and that is of course the ZT0055, which is a Gustavo Cecchini collaboration of ZT, which also features his spring-loaded tab feature, the SLT. Of course, it also has the regular S35VN of ZT and the KVT ball bearing system. It is a little bit a large knife. It is 3.75 inches, so a little bit larger than I normally like to have. My sweet spot is between 2.75 and 3.5, roughly. It is also a little bit heavy because it is, of course, a full titanium construction. It weighs in around 5 ounces, and the price will be around $220. So certainly a really interesting design piece, very good looking. I'm very happy that ZT picked up GTC knives for a collaboration, but I would like to see something a little bit different, something more interesting, not just a stonewashed titanium. I thought they could do a little bit better there, anodize it, finish it a little bit differently. Then I would be more interested in this knife, but I certainly have to take a hard look at this one. It also has a pretty nice blue anodized aluminum backspacer, so that is certainly a little pop of color there. But other than that, the ZT lineup was not particularly my cup of tea. I like the smaller Sinkevich collaboration that they have. But other than that, I was not blown away by their lineup. Then next up, I have one of my highlights of the show, actually, which is the CRKT Crossbones, which is a design of Jeff Parks, a longtime employee of Ken Onion, who also designed here the Ripley you see right there. And it's a really cool design, and these are the designs that I really like from CRKT, the aluminum-handled liner locks with IKBS, and a little bit upgraded steel from their normal stuff. It is still only AUS 8. I would like to see them step up their game to a S35VN or something like that. So that would be nice. But other than that, it's practically the exact same as the Jeff Park Mid-Tech Crossbones. So really interesting there. Very affordable, under $100. You get a 3.5-inch blade and only a weight of 2.4 ounces because it, of course, is made out of aluminum, which is really nicely finished in my opinion. And then you have a steel liner lock in there, so nice slender carrying piece, a nice deep carry clip, a really nice way to get your hands on a Jeff Parks design. And I certainly see the impact that Ken Onion had on him, because Ken Onion made some of the best CRKT collaborations for sure. Then next up, we have a Spyderco knife, and that is a little bit surprising to me because I'm mostly not a big fan of the standard Spyderco aesthetics. But the Spyderco Hanan really impressed me. It is a solid collaboration, I believe the third or the fourth bred solid collaboration that they have done. And it is a compression lock flipper, so the second that they have introduced alongside the sliver. And really good looking. I'm not crazy about the recurve on that blade. It will be pretty hard to sharpen, but if that was just a normal cutting edge, that would be awesome. But still, even with the recurve, I might consider picking one up, just because of the overall look is pretty nice. I also would like to see something different than G10 for the handles there. I actually like the bolstered look, even though it's going to make the knife a little bit heavier. Also, a wire clip or something like that would be a nice addition. I'm not too crazy for the clip that they have used there. But other than that, a cool design, nice and compact, not too Spyderco-esque in the overall design. Sticks to the Brad Sutter design like the other solid collaborations in my opinion. So that is certainly a nice thing from Spyderco. It also has the S30V steel, which is good to go for me. And then something really neat that I saw on the Knife News site, never saw in any other video on YouTube for some reason, and that is actually a Fox collaboration with Jesper Voxnes, a Danish designer, and it is called FX528TUR. And this one really blew me away. I really have to get my hands on this one. Very good looking. It actually reminds me of the Alexander Chebukov Strish, that I have taken a look at in the past weeks. Very, very good looking knife. It is a 3D machined carbon fiber handle with a inset liner lock. Then you have a 3D mil titanium pocket clip and a 3-inch LMAX steel blade. Very, very nice looking, a standard thumb stud deployment. Just a very nice EDC piece. Also an interesting backspacer on that knife as well, and made in Italy by Fox in Maniago. So certainly a knife to look at, and one of my highlights of the show, together with the crossbones actually. And then I have two other knives that kind of impressed me, especially for the price points that they come in. And these are two Kershaw knives. So the first one will be the Kershaw Reverb, which is a really interesting, lightweight, clip to your backpack style of knife with the standard ACR-13 MOV steel. But you also are getting here a G10 carbon fiber laminate that you are used to seeing from some Spyderco's and things like that. And the weight on this knife is only 1.6 ounces. You have a deep carry pocket clip and a 2.5 inch blade. And for the low prices that these knives go for, I think it is certainly worth a thought, especially because the design looks really appealing to me. Very angular, very aggressive looking. I also like the fuller for opening the knife. Let's see how that actually works in use, but overall a very cool design. And the last one I would pick would be the Kershaw Fraction, which is a Jens Anser collaboration with Kershaw, and it is the only KVT ball bearing flipper that they've introduced this year in their Kershaw lineup. So very interesting here, also very lightweight, just under 2 ounces, standard ACR-13 MOV steel. And then you also have a 2.75 inch blade and the same G10 carbon fiber laminate and a black deep carry clip. So these two knives really build a nice pair for me. I like that they are introducing G10 carbon fiber laminate at a very affordable price. And the designs just speak to me. They are lightweight, certainly really good low budget EDC pieces here from Kershaw. I think Kershaw really outdid themselves in the value department with the things that they have brought to the market. I also like some of their new Emerson collaborations, even though they are large and quite heavy, but they really look very nice. And also CRKT had some other things that I haven't featured here, like the Pilar or the Whistle. So really cool collaborations here from a lot of different companies. But these are my picks: the ZT0055, the CRKT Crossbones, Spyderco Hanan, Fox Knives, FX528TUR. I really recommend you to search that video on Knife News. I'm also going to link to the page down there in the description. Really, really cool knife, and I think more people should take a look at that. And then the two Kershaws, the Reverb and the Fraction. So tell me below in the comments, what are your top picks of the SHOT Show? Which knives are you going to get from the new ones this year? And which company did disappoint you with their lineup? So, of course, the elephant in the room here as well is Benchmade. Didn't release one single knife that interested me. Maybe the Anthem, but not quite. And all the other things are just not up to par with the other knife manufacturers. Thanks to Doctorfrunky for tagging me, and to Kevin Cleary and Nick Shabazz for participating in this little SHOT Show overview video thing here. And if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments below. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear videos, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.